This is the Bobcat News with your anchors, Finley Roseberry and Quinn Corcoran. Where every Bobcat matters every day.
Bonjour, Bobcats.
We are back with another broadcast, Bobcats. And here's the riddle. Why did the kindergartner bring a ladder to school?
We have students who have shown our Bobcat traits and are respectful every day. Callie and Cassidy will talk to our feature students.
Hi, Bobcats. I'm here with the fourth grade feature student, Charlie Locke. So, what kind of books do you like to read?
I usually like to read historical fiction books.
Do you participate in any after-school activities like sports or music?
I participate in wrestling.
What do you enjoy doing outside of school?
I like riding my motorcycle and my bike and just playing outside.
What do you like about Baldwin Creek?
I like how you're pretty free and all the teachers are nice and people like to treat you how you like to treat them.
Thank you.
Hi, Mariah.
Hi.
What kind of books do you like to read?
Fiction books.
Okay. Do you participate in any after-school activities like sports or music?
No.
What do you enjoy doing outside of school?
Riding my bike.
What do you like about Baldwin Creek?
It has more teachers, and the teachers are nice.
Cool. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Six teachers went to a literacy conference last week. Alex will find out how they will bring that learning into our classrooms.
Hi, Bobcats. Today I'm here with Ms. Staten to interview her about the literacy conference she went to last week. So, Ms. Staten, what was the conference about?
The conference was a reading and writing conference all about literacy and how to help students improve their reading and writing.
Why did you go to the conference?
Well, I was asked by Mrs. Powell and Ms. Hickola if I would be interested in going, and I felt that it would be a good learning opportunity for me, and being in the resource room, it would give me lots of information about how to help my students.
What did you learn from this conference that you would like to teach kids in our school?
Oh, we learned lots of things about how writing impacts reading and how we can improve kids' writing with strategies like 12 important words. We learned a lot about morphology, and Ms. Cessna and I got really excited about things that our school is doing really well with morphology and sentence work. And so we have lots of good things in our pocket now to do with all of you.
Okay. And is there anything you'd like to add?
Well, we had a really phenomenal speaker at the very beginning. His name is Mickey Smith. So if you get a chance, look him up on YouTube. He's pretty cool.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Staten.
Thank you.
Let's hop into weather with Asa.
Hey, Bobcats. Are you here for next week's weather? Well, then let's get into it. Monday will be very cold, with a high of 12 degrees and a low of negative 9. There will be a 68% chance of snow, so it will probably snow. On Tuesday, it will be even colder, with a high of 4 and a low of negative 13. It will also have a 14% chance of precipitation, a cold, cloudy day. Next, on Wednesday, there will be a 7% chance of precipitation. The temperature will have a high of 9 and a low of negative 6. It will be partly cloudy. Thursday will also be partly cloudy with a high temperature of 20 degrees and a low temperature of 1 degree. There will be a 3% chance of rain or snow. Finally, on Friday, there will be a 2% chance of precipitation and partly cloudy weather. There is a high of 28 and a low of 7. It seems like it will be way colder next week. Always make sure you are prepared and ready for the weather. This means bringing coats and jackets when it gets cold. Anyway, I've got to go. See you next week, awesome Bobcats.
Here's Emmett with our sports broadcast.
Hi, Bobcats. It's Emmett here with sports again this week. The hockey players will be on the ice in Denver this weekend. Good luck, hockey players. The swimmers had their conferences last weekend in the Lander, and they took first place. Cam Waltman was the Bighorn Basin District High Point champion for his age group. So I'm here with Cameron Waltman to interview him about his swimming. Okay, how did you place in swimming?
I got first, second, and third in everything. I did.
Nice. What are some events that you did?
I did the 200 free, 100 free, 500 free, 50 fly, and 50 back.
Nice. How did you feel about your achievement?
Good.
And who are some people that you swim with in Lander?
Well, we have Gavin, Alex, Carson Blackburn, and that's pretty much it.
Thanks. Wrestlers were on the mats in Cody last weekend. In fourth grade, Ryan Nicholas and Beckham Jacobs both placed first. Logan Freeman placed fourth, and Treffen Herman placed sixth. In fifth grade, Wyatt Day placed first and fourth, Brayden Gormley placed second, Quinn Corcoran placed third, and Tanner Gwena placed fourth. The climbers just came back from a climbing competition in Gillette, and next Friday they have one in the Rock Church. The gymnasts competed in Rock Springs last weekend and did very well. They took first place as a team. Elena Blackburn was first place in all events and all around. Janine Martin placed first place in the floor event. Anna Christian placed third and fourth events. Kinsey Conalog placed fifth in all around. Cassidy Schaefer placed second in all events. And Haley Marshall placed second on floor and beam, third on vault, fourth on bars, and third in all around. Good job to all the gymnasts. Charlie Locke competed in the ice races at Boyson Reservoir last weekend. Miss Powell will share some info with us for volleyball. Hi, Miss Powell. Can I ask you some questions?
Absolutely.
The first one is, what is open gym?
So this open gym is specific to volleyball. And so open gym is literally open gym, so anybody can come. This open gym is for fifth and sixth grade students, boys or girls, and we just work on volleyball skills. So we learn about passing, setting, serving, and then play lots of different games to improve your skills for volleyball.
Nice. And where is open gym?
So open gym is at the high school right across the street, and it's on Tuesdays from 6 to 7 in the auxiliary gym, so the back gym of the high school.
Nice. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Stay active, Bobcats, and I will see you next week.
We heard the chairs quit in Ms. Schneider's and Ms. Berry's classes on Tuesday. Nathan will talk with Ms. Schneider about the fifth grade writing activity that took place this week.
Hello. Can I ask you some questions?
Yeah.
So the first question is, how did you come up with the chair writing?
Oh, okay. So I actually found it online. Some other teachers online had shared that they did this activity to help encourage their kids to get excited about the writing that they were doing. I tweeted a little bit for our purposes, but really just kind of ran with it and pitched it to all the teachers here.
All right. How does this help our writing?
So this helps our writing because it helps get kids really engaged and excited about their writing. Sometimes we do some prompts that aren't as exciting to all of our kids. Some really love them. But this one I figured would be a fun way for the kids and you guys to come in, see that, oh my gosh, there's no chairs, and be excited about how can we argue our point on this. How was my date? Did I like not having the chairs? Was I more engaged? Or did I really just want my chair back all day long? So it really helps just give you guys a really personal experience to that writing piece and makes it a lot of fun.
Did the students like this activity, and did you enjoy this activity?
So I think most of our students enjoyed the activity. I had a couple kids who were like, oh my gosh, Ms. Schneider, where did the chairs go? Why can't you give them back? But for the most part, everybody was pretty excited about it. Today I even had kids who were like, do we have to sit in the chairs? Can I sit on the floor? And kids who did really well without the chairs. I loved it. I thought it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed coming up with the signs and taping up the chairs and just seeing everyone's reactions as they walked into the room.
All right, thank you.
Yep, thank you guys.
And Grace, we'll talk to some students who took part.
Hello, Pruitt. What was your initial reaction to having no chairs?
I thought it was pretty fun. It was definitely a first, but it's cool that we're creating a writing out of it, and it's a fun prompt. But I don't know if I'd want to do it again. Kind of hurt my legs, but yeah.
Hello, Corbin.
Hello.
How did you feel about the writing project?
It sort of sucked that we have to stand up, but it was actually pretty fun that we got to write about. It's sort of like when the crayons quit, so it was sort of fun.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The winter months can be a little boring and inactive. Caroline and Kelly have a fun science activity for us. Let's see what they are doing.
Hi, Bobcats. Welcome to Science with Callie and Caroline. Today we are doing an experiment with Expo marker, a glass pan, and water.
So what we do first is we're going to draw a picture in the bottom of our glass bowl. Now we're ready to pour the water in. Make sure you pour it in very slowly, otherwise it will
break apart.
Yes.
So here's my finished product. Only the fish survived, but that's okay.
Do try this at home.
Here are the reminders for next week. There's a lot, so make sure you listen up. The lost and found is overflowing. Please remember to check it often.
Students have a day off on Monday.
Spring pictures will be taken on Tuesday morning. Parents can order pictures online or by sending back the picture envelope. We only take pictures of students who are purchasing spring pictures.
NAEP testing for 100 of our fourth graders will happen next Wednesday. Please remember to keep voices at a level 1 or lower in the hallways.
The school spelling bee will take place on Wednesday, February 23rd. We will report on the results next week. Good luck to all the spellers.
Our hallways are looking messy. Please hang up your coats on the top hook, tuck your gloves and hats inside your coat or backpack, put your boots against the wall neatly, and keep your backpack zipped up and on the bottom hook.
Food and drinks are not allowed on the playground. The only exception is for the students who buy hot chocolate from the Bobcat cart. You may take this to the playground, sit on one of the benches, and enjoy your treat. Remember to make sure that your garbage makes it in the garbage can.
There are a lot of balls and playground equipment that is getting left on the playground each day. Make sure to put all the balls and the equipment in the wagon at the end of each recess.
Keep walking or running to earn those blazing Bobcat miles, and keep reading to reach your AL goals.
You want that answer to that joke? It was because she wanted to skip to high school. Bye, Bobcats.
Arrivo, Bobcats.